Hi there, guys. Lovely to be with you all again today. We're looking at 1 Corinthians chapter 3 in the New Testament. You know, I've been talking on Facebook today about immature behaviour. That's something that's so frustrating to deal with. When those around us as adults are acting immaturely. I've been speaking already today about relationships. A number of you lovely ladies have been tiptoeing around your man for a number of months or even years, longing for them to grow up and be mature. But it hasn't happened. And now it's all over. And you're wondering if you can go on. Well, the answer is definitely. You can go on. And I'm praying for you. And God is with you. And it will take time, yes. And it will be painful, yes. And you'll need to watch your heart, yes. Don't go into a new relationship on the rebound. Give yourself time to heal. You don't need to prove anything. You're a lovely person. You're a wonderful person. And God has got a plan and a life for you. And He will help you through the process of grieving and getting over it and getting through and building your life. And God has got good times ahead for you. That is absolutely a sure thing. Immature behavior. Paul's talking about it here in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 in relation to a group of Christians, a Christian church. And you know, whether it's a swimming club or a football club or a family or a church, it can be spoiled by immature behaviour. And here Paul says there was jealousy among the people. There was quarrelling. There was fighting. People were wanting to do what made them feel good without regard to how others were feeling. And so this led to strife and conflict. And Paul's saying, no, you're acting like children. You're acting immaturely. I want you to grow up and be responsible and be mature. And let God work among you as a group of Christians. You know, the church, there's no such thing as a perfect church. But God wants us all to grow and to consider one another and to love one another and to respect one another and not to have quarrels and divisions among us as Christians or whatever group you belong to. Be a builder. Don't be someone that demolishes. Don't be in the demolition business. There are a number of buildings getting demolished around Motherwell at the moment. We've noticed a lot of dust on the windows and on the mantelpiece. Trixie was just saying yesterday, it's all these buildings that are being demolished around about us. And so it is. Well, the buildings have to come down and new ones will go up, and that's progress. But you know, when it comes to our relationships, when it comes to our club, our group, our church, our family, our marriage, God wants us to be in the building business, not in the demolition business. He wants us to work together, whether it's as a couple, as a family, as a group. God wants us to work together. You see, our God is into building. God's not into tearing down unless it's absolutely necessary. God is into building. And in the Lord Jesus, God is building something. He's building community. He's building His church. Jesus said, I will build my church and the gates of hell will not stand against it. And so we find that Jesus is into building. Don't be a wrecker. be a builder. So many of us, through immaturity, have wrecked our marriages, we've wrecked our families, we've wrecked our relationships, we've wrecked our club, we've wrecked our churches. And it's all through immature behavior. It's all through not being all that God would have us to be. I know we can't be perfect, but we can be loving, and we can be kind, and we can be considerate. And God wants to build these things into our lives. So let Jesus help you. Take him onto the throne, the center of your life. Give Jesus the steering wheel of your life and say, Lord, forgive me. Come into my life. Make me the man, the woman, the fella, the girl that you want me to be. And God will do that. He longs to bless us. He longs to help us to grow and be mature and be all that we can be in our home, in our community, in our church, in whatever situation where God has placed us, where there are other people around us, that we can work together and build each other up and build something, build good. You know, one day it's all going to be looked at, you know. Every man's work is going to be judged. That's what we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 3. One day our work is going to be tested. And I wonder at the end of our life what we will have produced. Will it be something admirable? Something we can be proud of in all the right ways? Because we've built into people. We've built into relationships. We've built with love. We've built with God's help and with Jesus in control. Or is it going to be something that we're ashamed of? Our whole life has been a life of wrecking our own lives, our own homes, our own health, our own marriages, our own families, wrecking things in our community, wrecking things in the church. Or is it going to be something that we can be proud of, something that can be admired, something that will last forever and ever in the kingdom that is to come? It's our choice. Don't be a wrecker. I plead with you. Be a builder today. Put your hand in the hand of Jesus and say, Lord, let's go and let's build from this day on. Trixie and I love you all very, very much. Thank you for watching today. And take this little challenge and love today. It's intended to build you up. God bless. I don't have to fear anything, 'cause you're love.